This country has over 7,000 islands, making it one of the largest island groups in the world. Hello! Welcome to Opentiera. Get ready to explore the enchanting Philippines. From its breathtaking landscapes to its vibrant culture, we're taking you on a journey through the diverse and fascinating aspects of this beautiful country. Before the Spanish arrived, the islands we now call the Philippines were home to many different ethnic groups and tribes. They had their own cultures, languages, and ways of life. Some had organized societies with rulers and nobles, while others lived in small, scattered communities. Trading with neighboring islands and lands brought in new ideas and influences over the centuries. In 1521, the Spanish explorer Ferdinand Magellan landed in the Philippine Islands and claimed them for Spain. However, he was killed that same year in the Battle of Mactan while trying to colonize the islands. It wasn't until 1565 that Miguel López de Legazpi established the first permanent Spanish settlement in Cebu. 6 years later, in 1571, Manila became the capital of the Spanish East Indies colonial territory. For over 300 years, the Philippines remained a colony of Spain. During this time, there was resistance and rebellion from local Filipinos against Spanish rule. Towards the late 1800s, Filipino nationalism grew stronger. This led to the Philippine Revolution from 1896 to 1898, led by figures like José Rizal and Andrés Bonifacio. After centuries of colonial rule by Spain, the Filipinos sought independence. The Spanish colonizers brought their culture, the Catholic religion, and languages like Spanish to the islands. They built massive churches, forts, and cities like Manila using forced labor. While the Spanish clergymen and rulers lived lavishly, they heavily taxed the Filipino people. Though the locals adopted some Spanish influences, they maintained many of their customs and traditions too. After defeating Spain in the Spanish-American War of 1898, the United States took control of the Philippines through the Treaty of Paris. The Filipinos had fought hard to get independence from Spain, but now faced rule by another foreign nation. Many Filipino revolutionaries continued their fight for full independence from 1899 to 1902 in the Philippine-American War. Thousands of Filipino troops and American soldiers died in this long and bloody conflict. In the end, the U.S. emerged victorious over the rebel forces. For the next few decades, the Philippines was an American territory. The U.S. established English as one of the official languages and brought American-style education and government systems. However, many Filipinos still desired complete self-rule. In 1935, the Commonwealth of the Philippines was established, allowing some self-governance for the islands. Manuel L. Quezon became the first Filipino president, though the U.S. maintained ultimate authority. Then in 1941, during World War II, Japan invaded and occupied the Philippine Islands until 1945. Japanese imperial forces committed many atrocities against Filipinos. Major battles were fought between the Japanese, U.S. troops, and Filipino guerrillas, like the Battle of Bataan and the Battle of Leyte Gulf. Finally, after regaining control from Japan, the U.S. granted the Philippines full independence on July 4, 1946. This ended over 40 years of American territorial rule and nearly 400 combined years of Western colonization by foreign powers. The new republic faced lots of challenges in rebuilding after World War II. In 1965, Ferdinand Marcos was elected president, but he later became a dictator and ruled by martial law until 1986 when he was ousted by the People Power Revolution. After Marcos, the Philippines became a democracy again, but it struggled with problems like poverty, corruption, and conflicts with rebel groups. The economy grew in industries like tourism, but wealth remained unequal between rich and poor Filipinos. Though independent for over 75 years, the Philippines still works to improve issues of poverty and corruption that have challenged the nation since breaking away from foreign rule. The Philippine flag has two horizontal stripes of equal size, a blue stripe on top and a red stripe on bottom. On the left side of the flag is a white triangle pointing to the right. Inside the triangle is a yellow sun with 8 long rays coming out from the middle. At each of the 3 corners of the triangle is a small yellow star with 5 points. The blue color stands for peace and justice. The red represents courage and bravery. The white triangle means equality for all people. The 8 rays from the sun symbolize the first 8 provinces that fought for independence from Spain's rule long ago. The 3 yellow stars represent the 3 main island groups that make up the Philippines: Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. This specific design for the Philippine flag with the sun, rays, and stars was created and first used in 1897 during the revolution against Spanish colonizers. So the flag connects the modern nation of the Philippines to its historic struggle to become an independent country over 125 years ago. The Philippines is an island country located in Southeast Asia in the Western Pacific Ocean. Its capital and largest city is Manila. The Philippines is made up of over 7,600 islands, with the main islands being Luzon, Mindanao, and the Visayas Island Group. It borders the Philippine Sea to the east, and its closest neighboring countries are Taiwan to the north, Malaysia to the southwest, and Indonesia to the south. In terms of its size, the Philippines has a total land area of around 115,000 square miles, or 300,000 square kilometers. The climate in the Philippines is tropical and humid. Temperatures don't change much throughout the year. The average highs are around 82 degrees Fahrenheit, or 28 degrees Celsius, while the lows are typically around 77 degrees Fahrenheit, or 25 degrees Celsius. As of 2024, the total population of the Philippines is approximately 118 million people. The largest ethnic group is Tagalog at 26%, followed by Bisaya Binisaya at 14.3%, Ilocano at 8%, Cebuano at 8%, and Ilonggo at 7.9%. Other major ethnic groups include Bicol, Waray, Kapampangan, Maguindanao, and Pangasinan. Around 18.5% belong to other local ethnicities. The most widely spoken language is Tagalog at around 40%, followed by Bisaya Binisaya, Hiligaynon, Ilonggo, Ilocano, and Cebuano. Around 11% speak other native languages and dialects. In terms of religion, about 79% of Filipinos are Roman Catholic. Around 6% are Muslim, while other Christian groups like Iglesia Ni Cristo make up another 7%. The remaining population practices other religions or has no religious affiliation. The Philippines has produced many talented and successful people who have made their mark around the world. One of the most famous is boxer Manny Pacquiao. Pacquiao grew up in extreme poverty but became one of the greatest professional boxers of all time. He was the first boxer to win world titles in 8 different weight classes. Outside of boxing, Pacquiao has been a senator and military reservist in the Philippines. Another very accomplished Filipino is Lea Salonga. She is a singer and actress who was the first Asian actress to play the lead roles of Kim in Miss Saigon on Broadway, and as the singing voices of Princess Jasmine in Aladdin and F.A. Mulan in Mulan. Salonga has won many prestigious awards like the Olivier, Tony, and Grammy Awards. Bruno Mars is a popular American singer-songwriter who was born and raised in Honolulu, Hawaii, to a Filipino mom. Some of his biggest hits include Grenade, Just the Way You Are, and Uptown Funk. Mars has sold over 200 million records worldwide, making him one of the best-selling music artists of all time. In the world of fashion, Monique L'Huillier is a very successful Filipino designer. She was born in the Philippines but raised in the United States. L'Huillier is best known for her elegant bridal gown designs worn by many celebrities on their wedding days. From boxing to singing, music, and high fashion, these four talented Filipinos have achieved greatness and brought pride to the Philippines through their accomplishments on grand stages worldwide. Their stories inspire many to dream big. If you enjoyed this video on the Philippines, you'll love this next one.